We'll call the meeting of the Redevelopment Agency to order at this time. This meeting is being video recorded and streamed live to the web. Madam Clerk, can you please confirm posting and roll call?
Madam Chair, this meeting has been posted in accordance with the Nevada Open Meeting Law. All members of the agency are present and you have a quorum.
Thank you. Mr. Derrick, are there any changes to the agenda?
No changes, Your Honor.
Thank you. Can I have a motion to accept the agenda as presented?
I'll move.
We have a motion on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries.
Your first item is RDA 1, Minutes, Redevelopment Agency Meeting, November 20th, 2018. Your recommendation is to adopt.
Can I have a motion? We have a motion on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries.
The next item is RDA 2, Legal Services Invoice, Stradling, Yucca, Carlson, and Roth. Your recommendation is to approve.
Any comments from staff? Mr. Malloy?
Thank you. This is a request for the approval of budgeted funds in the amount of $118,633 to pay for legal services that this firm provided to the Redevelopment Agency.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? Can I have a motion? We have a motion on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries.
The next item is RDA 3, Grant Award Agreement, Downtown Tenant Improvement Grant. Your recommendation is to approve.
Mr. Malloy.
Thank you. This is a request for a tenant improvement grant in the amount of $7,370 to assist with improvements to the building at 331 South Water Street. The applicant for the grant is also the owner of the building. Her name is Angelina Azosostani, and she is here to address any questions that you may have. This is a dollar-for-dollar match. The application was reviewed by the National Development Council, and a finding was made that the award of the grant is warranted.
Thank you. Are there any questions or comments? Can I have a motion then?
I'll move to approve.
We have a motion on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries.
The next item is RDA 4, Grant Award Agreement, Eastside Tenant Improvement Grant, iCandy LLC. Your recommendation is to approve.
Mr. Malloy.
This is a request also for a tenant improvement grant. It's for a new business that will be locating at 200 East Lake Mead Parkway in the center where the Walmart is located, also at the corner of Water Street, or of Lake Mead Parkway and Boulder Highway. This application was reviewed by the National Development Council also. The facility is 4,000 square feet, and based on the maximum grant program benefits, the application would be eligible for up to the maximum grant of $55,000. But based on the recommendation for of the financials and the experience of this applicant, the National Development Council made the recommendation that the grant should be in the amount of $25,000, and staff have supported that request.
Thank you. Are there any questions or comments of Mr. Malloy or the applicant? Can we hear from the applicant, perhaps? You want to come forward and introduce yourself? State your name and your zip code for the record.
My name is Aaron Christensen at 200 East Lake Mead Parkway, Henderson. So the NDC has recommended $25,000 be awarded for the redevelopment grant, and I'm petitioning for the full amount of $55,000. My reason for this is our application, we exceed the redevelopment grant guidelines on every single level that has been outlined in the redevelopment grant guidelines. Also, the full amount will help our business, iCandy Salon Suites, achieve objectives that coincide with the objectives of the redevelopment grant, such as appealing to all residents in the surrounding area and creating a facility that appeals to those residents in Cadence, Lake Las Vegas, Calico Ridge, and even Anthem, and bringing those people into the downtown area to bring revenue and additional foot traffic and provide jobs in the area. Additionally, the NDC noted that the majority of the risk should be taken by the owner, and the majority of risk is being taken by owner. About 88% of the finances, even with a $55,000 grant amount, are covered by ourselves, as well as all future rent payable. And also, you know, as far as experience in this field, we believe we'll be very, very successful in that we have a lot of experience in our professionals in social media marketing. My wife has previous cosmetology experience and currently holds her license in that. And we have plenty of capital to hold the business over a month to month in any situation through the lifetime of our lease.
Thank you. Any questions or comments, Councilwoman?
I have a question. We had talked about this in briefings, but just for the record, you had mentioned that you're fronting $300,000.
That's correct.
And you were able to save that up in 3 years.
That's correct.
And so now you're looking for the remainder amount of $55,000, and that's going to get you to your goal of what you need to start up the business.
That's correct.
So right now the NDA is recommending a loan for or a grant for $25,000. So then you would be short $30,000. Is that right?
That is correct. Right now the total cost of the tenant improvements are $305,000. That's including everything that we want to do, including decoration of the interior and boosting the amenities to really appeal to the populations in Lake Las Vegas and Cadence in these areas. Without the total, with just the $25,000 grant, we'll have to make some cutbacks. And, you know, maybe go for cheaper flooring, cheaper decor, cheaper amenities. We will still open and run the business even without it. But in order for us to really achieve our goal that we want, we request the full amount.
And so is the owner yourself or your wife or both, or whose name is on?
We are both owners, 50-50.
Mm-hmm. So I'm curious, you know, $25,000 or $30,000, whatever is left over, mm-hmm. in the big scheme of it, I mean, you've already invested, you know, $300,000, and then you get another $25,000 from redevelopment. Have you looked to the bank to get a small business loan? I mean, it doesn't seem like it's that much of a loan to be able to bridge that gap.
We have considered seeking additional financing from banks, and we would be eligible for doing that. That goes against our own personal belief of trying to do this business in cash and not have an additional liability to be able to pay off, you know, loans with debts. It's not a huge amount, you know, that's something similar to maybe the value of a car, but our goal is to be able to create this business and make it profitable right away. And we've waited 3 years to be able to do that and save up our money in order to be able to make it debt-free.
So, and I understand that's your belief, but sometimes mm-hmm. in business you have to go get loans.
That's right.
So my other question is, I understand that it would be rent-free for 7 months, that the landlord would be allowing you to be there for 7 months free rent.
Yes, that's a deal we've negotiated with the landlord. We've negotiated the lease per square foot amount, and then we've also negotiated 7 months of free rent.
I think that's a pretty good deal.
That is
free rent. I mean, I know that you've already put in $300,000, mm-hmm. and then you're asking for the rest of it. I mean, to me, again, if it was me, and I'm not you, mm-hmm. and I'm not a business owner, but for that small amount of $30,000, I would think that if you went to the bank and you showed that, you know, how much money that you had put in there and what your business plan is and what you expect to get out of it, I don't know. And I'm not a banker either, so I don't know if you would get approved for a loan or not because I don't know you.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's what I would go for, just that small little amount, and it shouldn't take you that long to pay that back.
Yeah, that is a possibility. Additionally, one reason why we decided upon the location here in the downtown area is because we discovered the existence of the redevelopment grant, and that was a big draw for us to be able to bring our business into downtown Henderson as opposed to several other possible locations, which allowed us to get started on the business a little bit earlier. Pulling a loan out is something that it is a possibility, but it's, in my personal preference, I would have rather waited another 6 months as opposed to opening up a loan and paying interest on something like that.
And then one of the other things that we had discussed in briefings was your reserves, or, you know, are you able to sustain that the lease for 5 years? So can you talk a little bit about your reserves?
Yes, I can. So we do hold enough reserves for 6 months of costs and expenses in our personal accounts. And we also have sufficient personal income from our other business in order to float the business if it had $0 of revenue for the entire time without really damaging our quality of life. You know, we'd still be able to cover our bills and expenses.
And do you have independent contractors that are already lined up and ready to go once you open the doors?
Yes, we did. We actually filed a petition to be able to begin the tenant improvements before the actual grant was awarded. We signed our lease back in September, and we've had our contractor working on it since then. We have an expected opening date of January 15th.
How many spaces are rented out already?
Currently, we have five people who are interested. We've held off on showing the actual space until the facilities are a little more improved and it's safer to bring people in.
So you don't have anybody right now?
They're
just
not right now.
Some people who are showing interest, but nothing right now.
Yeah, we have a marketing campaign set up to begin in the first 2 weeks of January.
Thank you.
Any other questions or comments? Can I have a motion?
I do have one.
Okay,
Councilman. This is just philosophical, and this is, and I applaud you and your wife for the enthusiasm that you have. My issue is that you're taking a building that's been vacant for a year and a half, and you're putting in a sizable amount. You're asking the city to put in a sizable amount. You are improving the structure of the building for the landlord, who is putting in absolutely zero.
Right.
I find that, I just don't think that that's a good deal. Personally, I don't think it's a good deal for you or the city. But that's a decision that you have to make. It's easy for him to give you 7 months because he's not getting anything at all. But the landlord should be, in my opinion, helping you with the build out of your space to make it a viable business for you, and he's not. So the only people at risk here are you and the city, and I find that hard to support long term. I'm willing to give you the $25,000. I'm willing to put the city at risk for that, but if the landlord had to come in and given you funds, then I would have maybe changed my mind. But I just can't go past the 25 myself. So I'll make a motion to approve this grant for the 25.
We have a motion on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries. Best of luck, and we will certainly be here to support you in other ways.
Okay, thank you.
Next item is RDA 5, Grant Award Agreement, Downtown Sign Grant, Eye Candy, LLC. Your recommendation is to approve.
This item is companion to the previous item that you just heard. The maximum sign grant benefit or award is $2,000, and staff is supporting and recommending approval for the $2,000.
Thank you. I have a motion. We have a motion on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries.
Next item is RDA 6, Agreement, Exclusive Negotiating Agreement, Water Street and Victory Road, Site A. Bella Hospitality Group, LLC, your recommendation is to approve.
The Redevelopment Agency has been in discussions with Bella Hospitality Group for the development of a mixed-use project on Site A. We are requesting approval to enter into an exclusive negotiating agreement with a term of 6 months so that we can further explore this opportunity, define the scope and size of the project, and the portion of land that the Redevelopment Agency would be prepared to sell to the applicant. I would like to read in one correction in the actual exclusive negotiating agreement. It's on page 2 of that document, section 3, in reference to the fee deposit. The fee amount that it states in there should actually reflect that we are requesting a deposit of $25,000, whereas currently it says $15,000.
We're requesting $25,000?
We are requesting $25,000. Of that, $5,000 is non-refundable, and it's a fee that the agency will retain. The $20,000 will be applied towards the deposit if we enter into a land purchase and sale agreement and be paid to escrow. Otherwise, the $20,000 would be refunded to the applicant.
Thank you. Can we hear from the applicant? Mr. Hitchin.
Good evening, Madam Chair and board members. Stuart Hitchin, 2256 Dogwood Ranch Avenue in Henderson, 89052. On behalf of Bella Hospitality Group, their principal members are here with me. And we really, really appreciate staff's support on this. We briefed with you. Really here to answer any questions you have or anything you want discussed on the record. Glad to do that with you.
Thank you. I do have a couple of cards, folks that want to speak. First is Tim Brooks. Tim, if you'd come forward and state your name and your zip code for the record.
Madam Chair, members of the board. Tim Brooks, 120 Market Street, and I'm here as a business owner and property owner in downtown Henderson to give our full support of this project brought forth by Mr. Hitchin and his group. Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much. And Wyndham Kimsey, come forward, state your name and your zip code for the record.
Wyndham Kimsey, 314 South Water Street, also here as a business owner, and I just want to support this project, having been involved with redevelopment in downtown Water Street, both this one and I believe your next item, which is, sorry, really 7 is right across the street from our offices and our development. But I am just want to give my wholehearted support to this project, and I think it's a major tipping point for downtown, and I look forward to it.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Are there any questions or comments from council members?
Yes, I just want to mention that we also received a letter from the Henderson Development Association. And Amber, you want to come up?
Please state your name and your zip code for the
apologies. Letter. Amber Stidham, Henderson Chamber of Commerce, 89002, where I live, 89074, where I work. I just like to concur with the folks that came up to state their intent to support this project, too. From the Henderson Chamber of Commerce, Henderson Development Association, we support this project because it's the intended purpose of the parcels of land, both for this one and for the next agenda item. Also, we like that it's owner-occupied for continued investments, and we also like the fact that this redevelopment project will be led by someone who has hands-on experience doing redevelopment projects in the downtown area. So with that, I ask for your support.
Thank you. Any questions or comments of the applicant or of staff?
Actually, I just want to disclose that I'm an ex officio member of the Henderson Development Association. I'm not a voting member of that. I was there as a member of the council. Also, at that meeting, Stu Hitchens is also on the Henderson Development Association. He abstained, and for the record, so did Wyndham Kimsey, who's the chair of the HDA. So just wanted to put that on for the record.
I should also disclose that I am a member of the Henderson Chamber Board, but an ex officio member, a non-voting member, and this item did not come before us at the chamber.
Correct.
Thank you. Well, I think this is an exciting opportunity for downtown. And I think, as Wyndham said, we are at a tipping point for downtown Henderson, and to have something that might be an exciting mixed-use project that will bring more vibrancy to the downtown, along with projects that we're already seeing being successful, like Juan's Flaming Fajita, Love Lady Brewery, Hades, Public Works, TSK Architecture, and so many other things, the Gold Mine Bar. There's so many things that are happening in the downtown that we really are at an exciting time, and I think we'll look to give 6 months to see if we can make this project work. I think it could do some more exciting things for the downtown as well. So any questions or comments, or can we have a motion?
Yeah, I agree, Mayor. I'll go ahead and move to approve the exclusive negotiation agreement.
Okay, we have a motion on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries. Thank you.
Next item is RDA-7, agreement, exclusive negotiating agreement, Water Street and Basic Road, Site C, Bella Hospitality Group, LLC. Your recommendation is to approve.
Anthony Malloy, representing the Redevelopment Agency. Similar to the previous item, this is a request to enter into an exclusive negotiating agreement with Bella Hospitality Group. The Redevelopment Agency staff have been working with the potential developer on defining the scope and size of this project. We're excited and encouraged by the steps that we've been able to make to this point. We're requesting a six-month term with the exclusive negotiating agreement. I do need to read in one correction. In the exclusive negotiating agreement, page 2, section 3, under the fee. So somehow the numbers were flipped. So on this item, it should actually read that the deposit is in the amount of $15,000 and that $5,000 is non-refundable and is a fee that we will collect.
Any questions or comments?
Yeah, I'd like to, since this is a different agenda item, that I'm ex officio member of the Henderson Development Association, and I know that we received a letter in support from the HDA, so I did not vote, as well as Mr. Hitchens is the vice chair of HDA, and he abstained, and so did the chair of HDA, Wyndham Kimsey, and he abstained from that vote, too.
And I guess just out of an abundance of caution, I should disclose that I'm a Henderson Chamber member, board member. I am a non-voting ex officio member of that board, and this item has not come before us. We have a motion to approve on the floor. Please vote. And that motion carries. Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations. And the next item is chairman or board member comments. Does anyone wish to comment on anything at this time? This is the time for the final public comment period for the Redevelopment Agency. Is there anyone wishing to speak on a Redevelopment Agency issue? Seeing no one, we'll go ahead and adjourn this meeting of the Redevelopment Agency, and the committee meeting will start.